This week on The Wire, RBA says the recession is over, housing affordability the best since 2009, and buyer demand outweighs listings. G'day guys, my name is Tim Guest and welcome to The Wire, the week in real estate where you can get all the top stories happening this week in finance, real estate, investment and more. Now please like, comment and share this video. And if it's your first time tuning in, don't forget to follow or subscribe wherever you are seeing us. So let's kick it off with our top story for the week. RBA says the recession is over. So Reserve Bank Deputy Governor Guy Debelle says the RBA now believes the country's first recession in three decades ended in the September quarter. He says, as best as we can tell, the growth elsewhere in the country was more than the drag from Victoria. Now, ahead of a highly anticipated RBA board meeting next Tuesday, when the cash rate is likely to be reduced by a further 0.15 percentage points to 0.1%, Debelle told Senate's estimates that our best guess is it looks like the September quarter recorded positive growth rather than slightly negative. And as best as we can tell, the growth elsewhere in the country was more than the drag from Victoria. And possibly the drag from Victoria was a little less than what we guessed back in August. And that's coming from Guy Debelle. The bank's August statement of monetary policy said the effects of the heightened activity restrictions in Victoria are likely to offset the pickup in GDP growth in other parts of the economy in the September quarter. Now, the RBA will release a new set of forecasts in its quarterly statement on monetary policy next Friday. Now, guys, for our next story. So housing affordability is the best since 2009. Housing affordability is the best level since 2009 because of low interest rates and falling house prices in the biggest cities. And this comes from Moody's Investors Service. Moody's Vice President Elena Chen says housing affordability improved in Sydney, Melbourne, Perth, Brisbane and Adelaide over the year to September. House prices fell on average 1.5% over the 5 months to September, though prices are still up 3.2% over the year. And most price declines occurred in the two biggest cities. On average, Australian households need 23% of their monthly income to make mortgage payments, compared with 25% a year ago and 26% on average over the last 10 years. Sydney remains the least affordable, with new borrowers needing 30% of household income to meet repayments, and that is compared with 25% in Melbourne. Borrowers in Adelaide and Brisbane need only 19% of their household income for their mortgages, while Perth is the standout and most affordable city, needing just 15%. And now, guys, for our final story of the week, buyer demand outweighs listings. So nationally, residential sales are outpacing new property listings. Vendor discounts are falling and it's taking less time to sell a property. And that shows the latest CoreLogic data. The median vendor discount eased across the capital cities and regional areas in the 3 months to September, falling from 4% to 3.3% over the year. Also, it now takes an average of only 40 days to sell a property compared to 46 days a year ago, and that's coming from this new data from CoreLogic. Tim Lawless, CoreLogic's head of research, says the year-on-year comparison is highly relevant, as a year ago the marketplace was emerging from a two-year downturn. It does show that, as we emerge from the COVID-related lockdowns, the market seems to be a little bit stronger than that. Now, in the 4 weeks to September 27, new listings rose 9%, while total listings declined, leaving the ratio of homebuyers to new listings weighted towards demand rather than supply buildup, says Lawless. This suggests that now is the right time to buy. Well, guys, they're the top stories for this week. Now, please don't forget to like, comment, share this video, and follow or subscribe wherever you are seeing this. Have a great, great week. And remember, there is only one thing in life that makes a difference, and that is action. Thanks a lot, guys, and bye for now.